Today, pro-lifers in the state are putting more pressure on the embattled governor over his support for a pro-abortion bill. Capitol Hill correspondent Jason Calvi hears from the voices standing up for the voiceless in Richmond, Virginia.
They took time off work and school to remember kids who aren't here.
Our school is really pro-life, and we've been taught being pro-life, and we just believe that all humans have the right to life, no matter how old they are, if they're in the womb still.
We look at the scriptures, and it talks about how whenever the baby is in the mother's womb, the Lord knew that baby.
They stand up at the state capitol after Virginia Delegate Kathy Tran introduced a bill that would have allowed abortion up to birth.
My bill would allow that, yes.
Virginia Governor Ralph Northam supported the now failed bill.
The infant would be kept comfortable. The infant would be resuscitated if that's what the mother and the family desired. And then a discussion would ensue between the physicians and the mothers.
Those words led to national outrage.
I think this is a triumph out of tragedy. We've become a laughingstock around the nation, but quite frankly, it's started to stir a movement, not just in Virginia, but I think nationwide. That life matters, and that we're not going to allow politicians to write laws that amount to government legislative murder.
Bill Stanley and his fellow Republicans hold a two-seat majority in the state Senate. And Democrats have been gaining seats in recent years, but pro-lifers in Virginia are focusing their attention on this issue.
We're living in a time that is unbelievable, and people to just kind of yawn at it and not realize the seriousness of it. If you're a Christian, this issue ought to trouble you to your core.
This is an election year here in Virginia. Every single state Senate seat, every single House of Delegates seat's up for grabs this fall. And pro-lifers are hoping this enthusiasm will continue to motivate people to vote pro-life this fall. Here in Richmond at the state capitol, Jason Calvi, EWTN News Nightly.